And good evening, I'm Toya Washington.
I'm Kathy Michaelby. A Milwaukee police officer stands accused of roughing up and planting drugs on a suspect.
While the department says the claims are unfounded, the man tells a different story, and he's telling it only to 12 News' Chloe Maroney.
Every time Lamar Barnes looks at the pictures of his bloody shirt, he gets chills. He says it's stained from a night of torture.
It's not right. It's not right. I mean, how do you expect to feel safe with the police if they acting like the criminals?
February 2004, Barnes was visiting a friend near 24th and Vine when he says a group of Milwaukee police officers approached him, for no reason handcuffed him, and tried to put cocaine in his pocket. Then Barnes says the officers took him into this house, beat him, and he says Sergeant Jason Mucha led the attack.
And then Officer Mucha punched me in the face. Then as I was placed in a chair, they kicked me, they spit on me, Officer Mucha choked me till I was almost unconscious.
Barnes was charged with drug possession with intent to deliver. He made a deal and served 14 months in jail. Now Barnes plans on suing the sergeant, the police department, and the city for $10 million. Circuit Court Judge Charles Kahn says during Barnes' trial, it came to light that 9 other people from unrelated cases had also accused Mucha of beating them and planting drugs on them over a 3-year period. But still, he remained on the department. The Milwaukee Police Association says there's no reason that he should have been removed.
What you have here is you have an officer who is a good officer, who is an aggressive officer, and he's out there doing the job every day. And when you do that, you're going to have complaints filed against you here.
Fisher says 3 official complaints were filed against Mucha, and they were taken seriously. Police Chief Nan Hegarty backs that up, saying, quote, all official complaints made against Sergeant Mucha were investigated and were determined to be either unfounded or not sustained, and therefore disciplinary action was not appropriate. But still, the allegations have now piqued the interest of Common Council President Willie Hines, and he wants the Fire and Police Commission to investigate.
And the outcome will do 2 things, restore his credibility, or be able to substantiate the allegations and take the appropriate actions against him.
Police Chief Nan Hegarty also released this statement. Sergeant Mucha was identified as an officer with a potential problem in early 2004. There appeared to be a trend developing. Training was therefore provided to address the issue. Hegarty went on to say that the department has not received any complaints about Sergeant Mucha since he was promoted in January 2005. The chief says that all of those who have filed complaints against Mucha have either been found guilty or pleaded guilty to the crimes that they were initially arrested for. Now, Barnes himself has a very long criminal record, and those charges include child abuse and drug possession. Live in the newsroom, Chloe Maroney, WISN 12 News.
All right, Chloe, thank you.